Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? How many stars do you see in Orion when you look up at the Hunter constellation at night? Most of us can see the three belt stars and four shoulder and knee stars, even from heavily light polluted areas. But there's a lot more that could be visible here. For example, where Orion's sword region is, his head, shield held up towards Taurus, or his club extended over his head, as many of those stars are third, fourth, and even fifth magnitude. Regular viewers of these videos know that Eyes on the Sky talks about light pollution reduction strategies. This week is about measuring light pollution, and everyone can do this. It's not only easy to do, it's necessary to understand the extent of light pollution around the world. The Globe at Night is a campaign designed to do just that. And taking part is as simple as looking up at the night sky and relaying to Globe at Night what you see, even if it's cloudy. Here's how it works. Go outside, let your eyes adapt to the outdoor illumination in your area, doing your best to shield direct lights from your view. Then take a look at one of several major constellations in the sky and report what you see, even if it's just clouds, with simple to read star charts that best match what's up there. Most people know the constellation Orion, for example, or at least have seen it, even if they didn't know what it was. The three belt stars nearly intersect the celestial equator, so Orion is visible from nearly every location on Earth humans live, in both northern and southern hemispheres. For those unsure where and how to start, when you go to the Globe at Night website, click on the Observe link. That will take you to a page that details the five simple steps to take next: finding the constellation to observe, determining your latitude and longitude, when to view, matching up your view of the sky with the provided star charts, and then reporting your data to Globe at Night. It's that easy. And if you have an Android smartphone or tablet, it's even easier than that. Download the free app, Loss of the Night, and follow the simple instructions. Make sure you have your GPS turned on so that the app can accurately assess your location. Then just tap on the Start Observing Stars. A circle with an arrow will appear and guide you towards progressively dimmer stars in the sky. It prefers 7 measurements, so keep inputting whether you can see a star or not until one is too dim to see. Then enter that information, and you're done. It only takes a couple minutes of time. What's great about the Globe at Night campaign now is that it has been extended to all months of the year. You can submit observations either by smartphone or using simple arrows pointing to visible stars all year long. Or, of course, use the star maps provided at the globeatnight.org website. And this year, you can choose from more than just Orion, Leo, and Crux. Southern Hemisphere observers can add Scorpius, Sagittarius, and Cetus to their options, and Northern Hemisphere observers can submit observations using Hercules, Cygnus, Pegasus, and Perseus. With so many options, why not help out with this effort to measure the extent of light pollution? More data means we can more accurately assess the problem, and then work to reduce it. Of course, your own efforts to actively reduce light pollution and light trespass are needed as well, either by installing motion sensors for outdoor lights, using shields to keep lighting aimed down at the ground, or using specialty light bulbs and post lamps to ensure lighting goes downwards and reduces glare at the same time. Every little bit helps. Mercury is rising in the western sky just after sunset, though it will be better placed next week, so stay tuned for spotting the innermost planet then. Jupiter wedges its way in between the two twins of Gemini, sauntering its way slowly towards the feet of Castor. The Moon, Mars, and Spica all gather together on the morning of January 23rd to share the same 6 degrees of sky with each other. 2 mornings later, the slimming crescent moon stops by to see Saturn, less than a degree and a half from the ringed sixth planet. And just before sunrise, Venus has veered to the other side of twilight and will be a morning star for the next 9 months or so. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.